I'm wearing a cowboy hat. I'm not sure why, but we're gonna do this. There are a few things in this world that sound as sweet as the sweet, sweet sound of Turbo Whistle. Let's face it, it's just so damn good.
Keep it down.
I'm trying to make a movie here. Having a good day, Turbo Whistle's gonna make you smile. You're having a bad day, Turbo Whistle, still gonna make you smile. Not sure if you're having a good day or a bad day, but you still just wanna smile, Turbo Whistle. And just like every good story, turbos also have a partner in crime. It's like Batman and Robin. This aluminum radiator looking thing helps keep your intake temps cool and ultimately brings you more horsepower. But how does an intercooler actually work? Which ones are good, and better yet, which ones are the best if you're chasing big horsepower numbers? Great news is I'm Dustin with Custom Offsets. You guys can follow me and my turbo diesel on the gram at dusty.co. And today, we're diving headfirst into this one to find out just which intercooler may be right for you.
Who is she and why are we intercooler?
As we're building the boost and spinning off the tires here, a reminder that if you need performance parts for your truck, we have those at customoffsets.com. While we have all sorts of things from intercoolers like we're talking about today to intakes and exhausts and tuners and a whole bunch more, we got a whole bunch of parts, right? It's pretty cool. Also, in case you've been living under a rock the last few weeks, we announced a new giveaway, and this one is big. And not like figuratively big, like actually big. Like rolling on 42s and 2616s big. That's right, we are giving away our newest SEMA truck, a 2017 Ford F-350 Super Duty on a massive Kelderman air ride lift kit. So first and foremost, what exactly is an intercooler and how does it work? An intercooler, by all definitions, is a mechanical device used to cool the intake air on an engine with either a turbo or a supercharger. Now that sounds fancy, but it really just actually goes a little something like this. Turbos and superchargers work essentially by compressing the air going into our engine. This compression packs more air into the cylinders, right? They call it boost, and it allows each cylinder to burn more fuel per stroke, ultimately making more power. Now, when the turbo or the supercharger compresses the air, right, creates friction. Friction creates heat. This heat causes the intake air to be less dense, right? Limiting the amount of fuel that you can put into the cylinder and then overall limiting the power, right? This is where an intercooler is gonna come in. Before this air enters the engine, it's gonna go through this intercooler and then external air is gonna come through the cooling channels, which inevitably lowers the temperatures on that intake air, making it more dense and ultimately getting after what we all want, which is more power. When it comes to intercoolers, there's two main types. You have air to air and air to water. Most commonly, and the ones we're gonna talk about the most today, are air to air intercoolers. These intercoolers use air that you're driving through to essentially cool your intake air, which is inside of it, right? It works a lot like a radiator. These are different than an air to water cooler, which actually uses a coolant system to cool the air. This would be like your actual radiator. These are gonna be more expensive, more complex, and overall just not as common as your air to air counterparts. It is important to note here that most, but not all diesels of today are going to come with an intercooler of some sort, unless you're Jared, who has a dinosaur 7.3 power stroke that is not intercooled for whatever reason. Ford just thought it wasn't a good idea, and that's probably why he lost the tow off, honestly. So let's say you're looking to upgrade your intercooler. Which intercoolers are worth talking about? Great news here, we actually have quite a few brands of intercoolers on the website that you guys can take a look at. For starters here, we're gonna take a look at the AFE intercoolers. Known as the Blade Runners, not to be confused with the 1982 sci-fi movie Blade Runner, these intercoolers pack a punch when it comes to performance for your money. They're gonna be thicker, they're gonna be beefier, and they're gonna be larger. These intercoolers have proven to lower intake temps up to 200 degrees, which is a whole lot when you live in a place where the air hurts your face like it does here in the good old Wisconsin. At least we don't have like hurricanes or fire ants or tornadoes, really, or anything else that wants to kill you, like alligators. The all aluminum design and TIG welds on the AFE are going to make this one a really great product for the money. Now, changing it up here a little bit, if you're looking for something a little bit nicer, Mishimoto may be the brand for you. These intercoolers, again, are gonna be TIG welded. They're gonna be available in all sorts of colors, including black, so, you know, Banker can be happy because he wants everything in black. And overall, they're just a really super solid quality product. These are all stock fit intercoolers, meaning that they're gonna bolt right into the stock location, which ultimately means that you won't have to like cut the shit out of your radiator support to make them fit or fabricate some brackets to get it up in there. It's just gonna bolt right in. Mishimoto has been in the industry a long time, so you know when you're buying a product from those guys that you're getting years of testing and product knowledge. They've been around since I was just a little kid and they continue to make really solid products. And of course, we couldn't talk about intercoolers without talking about the one and only Banks Power. Now listen, there's a lot of companies out there that talk the talk, but there are few that walk the walk as much as Banks Power does. Not only does Banks spend a ton of time on product engineering, but they also actually flow test every one of their products against every other manufacturer on the market, and they will not release a product unless it outperforms the competition. That's a fact. So what this ultimately means is that when you're buying Banks Power, you know you're getting the best of the best, and it's going to perform. When it comes to intercoolers and boost gains, Banks has test data that says that their intercooler increased boost over 45% more than stock. It gave them 12% more dense air than stock and gave them a whopping 96% more efficient cooling flow than the stock intercooler. All of this is cool. See what I did there?
Oh my gosh.
But the long and short of it is that the Banks intercooler is gonna give you more proven, tested performance time over time. With all of that being said though, you guys will have to let me know, have you ever swapped an intercooler in your truck, either gas or diesel? How was the result and how was the process of doing so? Let us know down in the comment section below. And as always, if you're looking for an intercooler, you can check us out at customoffsets.com. With that, I'm Dustin with Custom Offsets. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe so we can keep making videos like this. And we'll see you guys on the next one.